Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of City Skylines. My name is CityZilla, and today we are in the city of Canalville, where we are going to be working on this area. And I gotta say, I just absolutely love these fishing boats in here. I think that this waterway, with it being this active, just looks fantastic. And so on the last episode, we built out this lovely island with these key walls around the outside with the bike paths. And I talked about these new keys as well as the new piers here. And I just love these assets. I think they are fantastic. And today we're gonna be finishing this off, as well as building the zoo. And so I think it's gonna be super exciting. One of the things that we can do to boost this up is actually drop down our price a little bit. This will encourage more people to come here. This actually does affect how many people come. So if you have it raised up too high, less people will come. And so we're gonna go ahead and bump this down. I could go down to zero, but I think down to like three is good. So at least we still make some money, even though we're still running in the red. And so we are gonna be building out a small residential area and then a really elaborate zoo. And I got some fun ideas. I wanna do a couple waterfalls in here, and I want to integrate it with this road. And so before we jump in, I did want to mention two creators that I'm kind of taking inspiration from today. And one of them is ACC Original. He recently did a video on ponds and how to make them look realistic, and I just thought it was a fantastic video. And it is going to segue into some of our waterfalls today, and so I wanted to mention it. I'm gonna go ahead and put a link to the video in my description if you're interested in checking them out. And then the second creator is Grahtels. She recently did a zoo that I just thought was fantastic. She did a bunch of ponds, and I really got a lot of inspiration from it, and so I wanted to mention her as well. And so let's go ahead and jump right in. And so the first thing we want to do is level this terrain out. So we're going to grab our level terrain tool. We're going to increase that brush size a little bit, and I want to create a little bit of a plateau up here. That was kind of the whole reason why I wanted the road running right next to it. I want to create a space where people can come, and we'll probably have some of the zoo animals up here, and they can just overlook everything. Even though some of the tall buildings do kind of block the view, I still think it would just be really cool. What is that tram doing? How did they even get up there? Look at this poor tram. Wow, I didn't even notice this until we're on pause too. I don't know what they're doing. Where are they? Okay, so they somehow got stuck way up here. It looks like it's multiple of them too. Poor guys. I'm imagining the passengers are probably just freaking out, like not really knowing what's happening. But we came to the day and we deleted them. I don't know if that counts as saving them or not, but so back to what we were doing. We are going to grab the level terrain tool, and so I want to create a really cool entrance here. I felt like this was a good opportunity, like coming down to our pier area and the zoo, and because Ali Dupour, the person we had introduced in the last episode, actually owns all this land, this would all be a part of basically that same foundation. And so they want to create a really great entrance for it. And so what we're going to do is create a little waterfall entrance in here, and I think it's just going to look fantastic. I'm really excited about it. So we're going to go like that, and then we're going to do a little shopping center down here at the bottom with the waterfall and river running behind it. And I just think it's going to be really cool. And so we're going to come up here, and then we're going to drop this down real quick, and anybody who's watched me do little ponds and stuff before knows what to do. And so I do want this to be a little shallower. I don't want it to be too deep. I want the water to be pretty clear. And so now what I'm going to do is go ahead and create an inlet out here. So I'm going to go like that, and then we are going to do the same thing down here. And there we go. I feel like that's pretty good. We'll probably have to come in here and adjust this a little more. I'm going to go ahead and drop in this water source real quick. So I'm going to go like this, drop this all the way down, come up here. We're going to pause it since it makes it so much easier. And then the goal is to get it just high enough to where it's not coming up over the edge, but going over this break right here. So I think that's good right there. And then because the water is going to be falling into this corner, we actually need to do a couple. So we're going to go like right there, and then we're going to come up over here as well. So we're going to go like right there, and we're going to have to watch that road. If it starts to leak up on the road, we may need to move that around. And so now we should be able to unpause that. And while we're letting that fill up, I want to finish our levels over here. And so we are going to increase our brush size, and I want to create a couple nice spaces. So I think we're going to create a space right here, and then I want to create another space like right here. And then I think we're going to create a space over here as well. All right. And so I think for this section as well, we might have the road just butt right up to the cliff. I think that that's going to really create a nice effect and also create another viewing point for people within the zoo. And so I feel like that's a great opportunity for us. And so we're going to come over here. I think we may even extend this one out a little bit further. So we'll go like right there. I feel like that's great. I feel like that could probably be even deeper. So we'll go like right there and then clean this all the way up. So we'll have a little fountain up here. I think we'll do like right there. And then we'll have a secondary fountain and then a third fountain. And I think we will extend this out a little bit. And I want to kind of create a little separation in here. And there we go. It doesn't look bad. It looks a little sharp right here. We may need to soften that up. So we'll go in here and just soften that real quick. So I think for this section, what we're going to do is actually bring this back a little bit more. And then we'll actually have this drop down to the ground right here. I feel like that's just going to look so much better. And then that way we can actually bring this back a smidge and then create another tiered effect right there. And then I'm going to go ahead and draw in our fountains real quick, or our ponds. Okay, and there we go. So I decided to do a little pond in the middle of our zoo, and we're going to end up decorating it up and making it look really nice. And then I'm going to do some of those same waterfall things that I did before. All right. And so for this section, what we're going to do is actually use that pier key wall, because I really want to create almost like a downtown kind of city walk vibe almost with the pier. I think it's just going to be really great. And it's definitely something you see not a ton, but I think it's just a really cool idea. And what we're going to do is have it end right there. And so now it's like you go out shopping and you can kind of walk out on this fake pier in front of this waterfall. And it's just a really nice area. I don't know if we're going to have zoning off this main road, so I think we'll probably just have zoning off of that, and that way all the buildings actually face the pier. I feel like that's going to be a great opportunity. So we'll come in here and we will actually remove zoning off of this. Yeah, that's going to be perfect. Look at that. And we'll probably keep zoning right there, and we'll probably keep zoning right there as well. And then we do need to jump into a road. Let's go ahead and do a 4-unit road, and we'll have it come up right in the middle. And I want to do one with trees, so we'll have it go like right there, and let's go ahead and curve it in. Yeah, look at that. Perfect. This pier key does act like a road, and so you can drive on it. It's very minimal. It's extremely slow, and so it definitely discourages people driving on it a ton, but it's enough to give access, and so that's really what we need. And so now I think this looks great. Gonna do this high vegetation all the way around the edges, just to kind of clean it up, make it look like it's not a cliff face. And then I'm going to go ahead and put in rocks in here, and then do the same waterfall that I did before. Okay, and here we go. I definitely went a little crazy, but I wanted it to look good. And so we have a nice fountain pond going back here. And I honestly think we'll probably get rid of this and do a small key wall, just because this is going to be residential side facing. But then I did a standard pond in the middle. This is going to be more of like a seeing pond. You're not really going to go up to it as much. But then I did this grand entrance in the front, and I just think this looks great. I even think maybe getting rid of that boulder. I think this looks fantastic. Like, you're coming down, you may be coming into the amusement park or the zoo, and you just kind of see this. It just looks so great. I do think that these levels look a little off. Maybe we'll go ahead and level this out. So I was thinking the entrance right there, but maybe we'll put the entrance up here. I think that could actually be better. And then I went ahead and added in a key wall around here too, just because the ground looked a little weird. And then I was having some issues over here as well, so I felt like just kind of curving it around and having the key wall come up here just made a little more sense. Same with over here. I think we'll probably connect this up and then have it just terminate right at that rock. Yeah, there we go. I think that looks pretty good, and it allows us to do like a nice clean key wall look over here, though I do want this to be even. So we're going to grab all of our nodes, grab those, grab that, and then control H right there. Perfect. This is going to be a nice little look, because these aren't the new key walls. We do have some issues with that, but I'm not too worried about it. I did lower it down up here too for the bridge so that people could continue walking. I felt like that was going to be important. All right. I think this looks fantastic. And so I went ahead and put in this little tree thing here too, just kind of cover it up a little bit. I think it looks good. It does obstruct the view a little bit on this side, but I'm not too worried about it. All right. And so I think what we're going to do is use this side as our entrance. I don't really like this shape of the key wall. I feel like that's kind of incomplete there. It almost looks weird, but I think we're going to keep it right now. It does look like we have a fire over here. We do have fire coverage, right? Ooh, so it's way over there. All right, maybe we should plop down a little fire department right here. Go ahead and check our other coverage while we're at it. So medical's actually not bad. These people aren't doing terribly. I don't know why they're already light blue over there. That's kind of weird. And then fire coverage isn't great. Police coverage is good. This for some reason isn't the greatest, even though it is connected up to the key wall. So police department would be able to get there. But at least now this fire will be put out. Yep, it's already put out. Perfect. And so now we are going to put our entrance right here. And I want to do a small parking lot right next to it. And then we're going to do a few zoo main attractions. We're going to do some stuff over here. And then want to have some paths kind of meander past our lake and then do some more stuff back here. There's really a lot of fun opportunities here. And so we are going to jump into the park tool and go to zoos. Go right here. Bada bing. Yeah, perfect. Zoo main gate. We're going to go like right here. You know what? I think we're actually going to put it on the other side of a parking lot. So I'm going to go ahead and draw in a small parking lot real quick. And there we go. Super easy parking lot. Not super big, but I think good enough. Moose and reindeer enclosure, zoo side gate, zoo souvenir shop, antelope enclosure, zoo restrooms, birdhouse, zoo cafe, zoo plaza. Man, you really get a lot. I think you got quite a bit more than amusement park. So now what I want to do is create a little entrance plaza in here. So I want to have this go straight and then we're going to have it turn. And this is where we're going to put our little zoo plaza. And the reason is that kind of the same idea I did with the amusement park. Normally you have like a kind of main street kind of vibe going in, like a bunch of souvenir shops, stores, restaurants and stuff like that. So we're actually going to just replicate a lot of these and make it look like that's the case, even though these are the same buildings. We're just going to pretend like they're not. And so now we have a nice little main street here. I think we're going to go ahead and go like this. We're going to shuffle these back a little bit. I want to be able to put some trees in between them. So we're going to go like that, go like that. Yeah, perfect. And so let's go ahead and look at our reindeer enclosure. This one's actually kind of big. I think we will put the reindeer one over here. So we're going to go like right here. Yeah, perfect. Look at that. I do want to shift this around. I don't want it to have any weird clipping. Maybe we'll smoothen that out a little bit. That's not bad. It's definitely a little sharper than I was hoping, but so let's go ahead and go like right there. And then let's figure out our pathway now. So I want our pathway to kind of meander through here. Whenever going to zoos, at least the zoos I've been to, they tend to be really dense with foliage and stuff, and they're really kind of compact. Some of them are large, but it really depends on where you're going. But I think if we come up over here, and then what we're going to do is have it go over the road. Perfect. I really like doing the bridges too. I feel like that's a fun aesthetic. I feel like it's probably a little too tall, but we're going to go ahead and leave it like that. And so I do want to create a little bit of space down here as well for some more shops and another little plaza and stuff. And so let's come in here. I want to do plaza like right here. And then let's see about placing the shops around it. And so I do want to do these little shops like right here off the side. A lot of times, I mean, they make little clusters of these throughout the theme park and so, or zoo. And the goal is obviously to sell more merchandise or to provide food for people who are hungry and kind of staying. You want people to enjoy themselves. And so I think we're going to go ahead and do the birdhouse over here. And then we have the antelope enclosure. So the antelope enclosure is actually kind of small. So this piece looks like it might be big enough to fit one of the bigger ones. So I think we'll just focus on over here for right now. So we're going to do the birdhouse. I feel like this would be a good spot for it and go like right there. Perfect. And so let's go ahead and hook up a path to it. And there we go. So I decided to extend out our little plaza a little more. I felt like this was a good opportunity to just kind of roll these up together. And so now what I want to do is go like this, and then let's jump into a gravel path and create a nice little space in here. Nice. And so now we will come in here and kind of fill these spaces in with stuff. We can actually move these now. So we will go like right there, and then let's go ahead and put these next to them. Nice. And there we go. And so let's go ahead and look at our last building now. All right. And so the antelope enclosure. And so I would like to go back here and create another little space. So I think what we're going to do is come up over here, and we're actually going to have this path kind of sneak past this. Yeah, there we go. And then we're going to have it go next to the road, but follow the lake, because this is really going to be like the nice thing to see here. And so I do want it to follow the lake. So we're going to come up over here and have it curve, go this way. And there we go. So now we have created our first little space. And this was really the reason why I wanted to do the lake. I felt like this was just such a good opportunity to do something fun that looked good. And so let's go ahead and create another spot for our antelope enclosure. So I think maybe like right here would be good. So I think if we go like right there, and then let's go ahead and hook it up with paths. And there we go. And so now we can actually create another little space back here with some shops and another little area for people to grab some food. Or it looks like I just built the same building. I do wish that there was more like prop assets with this. There's really not a lot of buildings that you get with any of these parks. I think that's good for right there. Let's go ahead and check and see this. So not enough water. I'm going to go ahead and do water real fast. All right. So water is in. Let's go ahead and look at our main building now, because we really want to get as many people as possible. So we have 0 out of 500. So we got people walking, which is great. Let's go ahead and look at our tram line so that we can get a stop in here. Yeah. So it looks like we have a couple lines. So we can come down here to the transportation tab, go to trams, and then grab this and create a stop. Let's actually do Should we do both?
Yeah, so I think the purple one is the one that goes to the city. I think we want to get the purple one too. So we're going to do both of them.
And so now both trams will stop here and allow people to get into the zoo. And so the goal is for us to basically level this up as quickly as possible. We're going to go to 3-speed now. And let's see. Come on, we need to get our... So we got people coming in. We got somebody who's coming all the way over here. Oh, we got somebody going all the way back there too. Nice. And so we've already met our entertainment goal. And let's go ahead and drop this down just so that we can attract more people. And while I was building that out, we did hit our next unlock for this. And so now let's jump over here to our amusement park. So we're at 3,000 visitors out of 5,000. We definitely need to add in a couple more things. So let's jump in here, go to amusement parks. So if we do the swinging boat, the house of horrors, and the bumper cars, man, this is really a lot. We're getting a lot on this one. I think this is fantastic. So I think if we have the path go out this way, I think this could be good like right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and place that and then build a path back here. Yeah, look at that. Perfect. Just like this. It'll read the boardwalk, which is just fantastic. And so now we have little cars that like to run into each other, also known as bumper cars. And so now let's go ahead and add in, you know, a scary little dark ride back here. Little haunted mansion action. And so I think we're gonna go like right there. And then let's go ahead and grab our paths now. And there we go. Perfect. And so now we have a scary haunted mansion ride, which is fantastic. And looks like we got like a little alligator running around. There's a ton of little mascots. And so now hopefully that will boost us up even more. It's really, we're about 2,000 visitors away. I think, you know, I do think that we're going to be able to fit it in because I really want to get this decorated and kind of finish it off. And so while we're waiting for this to upgrade, let's go ahead and build out this residential area. All right, and so what I want to do back here is go ahead and create a nice little road. So we're going to grab a big road and we are going to curve it around. Perfect. And so the idea is for us to do a couple rows of grids in here, and I want to create a couple really fun spaces. I would like to do a little plaza, make it just into a nice area. Perfect. I feel like that is pretty good. I do wish that this was a little bit further, but it's not the end of the world. And so we'll come in here and we're just going to come up over here, and I want this to follow that same kind of direction as the other side. So we'll go like that. And you know, that's pretty good. It's not too intense, but it allows us to be able to get some nice zoning in here without doing too much. And so I'm going to go ahead and do some water pipes real quick. And there we go. Water pipes in. And so now let's go ahead and zone some of this in. I went ahead and made it self-sufficient because I really want to get some nice fun buildings in here. And there we go. So I went ahead and put low density commercial on the front side and then filled in the outside with high density residential. And so now we're going to get some really awesome self-sufficient buildings in there. So I do want to do a nice park in the middle. I think we're going to do a plaza and then we will kind of decorate it up, make it look really nice. Let's jump in here now and let's change those tiles to something else. And there we go. I think I'm just going to change them over to these other tiles. We could do the zoo one too, though. It actually looks really good. I like that one. So we're going to go ahead and do that, especially since we're next to the zoo. I think that's great. It's like those brown tiles. I think that looks fantastic. All right. So now what I want to do is go ahead and just create a couple little paths in here and just make it into a nice space. So I think we will grab a path and have it go across just so we can create some access. But then let's go ahead and turn off snapping and have a path go down the middle. And then what I want to do is create just a couple little nice spaces for this. So I think if we jump in here, we can grab our gazebo and place that in there. So if we go like that, and let's go ahead and flip it around. I feel like that's pretty good. It's super easy too. I didn't go above and beyond with this one, but I think it looks great. I think we have enough residential in here now to really beef these up, and that's really what I'm worried about. So let's look at this now. So 296 out of 500, we're definitely close. Let's see if a lot of people are coming. So actually, I mean, a decent amount of people are coming, and so we should hit our goal here pretty soon. Let's check our amusement park to see how far we are from there. So we're actually coming up on it, 4,000. We actually might hit level 4 in there. I would really prefer to. And so I do want to create a nice little space with this waterfront. That was kind of the goal with me not zoning anything over here. So I want to create a path and we're going to have it turn this way and then have it follow. I think we're going to do concrete, but follow the water. I think we may even upgrade these to ones with benches. Yeah, I think if we do this, yeah, that's perfect. Because then now they actually have little benches there too, which is just fantastic. So let's go ahead and raise that up as well. I feel like that looks pretty good. And so I'm going to go ahead and let the game run for a bit so that we can hit our next unlocks. All right. And so while we were waiting, I actually jumped in here and changed some of the policies. I turned on advertising campaign for both of them, but then I did celebrate and then night tours and animal ethics. I think it's just going to be really great for us now. We're actually really close to hitting our next unlock for both parks. Yeah, we're at 440 of 500. And while I was sitting here, I think we're actually
actually just going to extend this out. I really like this look. And even with our future marina here, I think that this is really going to work out. And so I'm going to go ahead and use the picker mod, and I'm going to grab our one-way tram road. And I'm going to go ahead and draw this all the way down to probably this section, and then I'll have it loop back just like we did the opposite side. And there we go. And so now I do want to connect up some other tram roads. So we're going to go in here and we're just going to go to a standard two-lane, two-way. I actually think, I wonder if that's a smaller one. Yeah, it is. Four-lane, two-way trams. So we're going to connect this up, go all the way down, and we'll connect it up to the key as well. Let's go ahead and connect this one up as well. And I'm just going to go all the way down to all of our crossings and connect them up. And there we go. So I decided to leave this one empty because this whole section right here is going to be utilized for our entrance into the marina. And so now what I want to do is go ahead and extend out our district here, and we'll go like that. I feel like this is going to be a really nice addition for this area. It looks like we do need to loop around our tram road over here though. It I left it unlooped, and so the trams would definitely be stuck. This is a tram road right here too, so we do have multiple avenues for them to turn around, which I think is fantastic. And I think we'll even get rid of these as well. We're going to come in here and let's go ahead and fill all this in. Now we're going to come like this. Perfect. And so now there's some awesome water-facing offices right next to residential, and so there's a lot of access, and we do have a lot of space in here. So I think what we're gonna do is do a path. We have more space than we did on the other side, so I'm gonna grab this path and I'm gonna go ahead and draw them in the middle real quick and just make some connections that will help the area out. And there we go. I just decided to cut them across, make it a little bit easier for people to travel around. I think we're gonna go like this as well and connect them up. I think this would be a really good idea. We'll probably connect them up to the key too, so that people can walk down. And I think we may do some more organic and local produce on the front side of this like we did on the other side. And so now we did hit our unlock for the zoo, and so I think it got us to, so now we need to reach 2500 guests, and we're climbing pretty steadily now that we did that the advertising campaign. And so I think we should be able to hit our next unlock too. So we're going to come in here now, and I think we unlocked two buildings. So we did the antelope enclosure was the last one, so we have the bison enclosure, which I believe is kind of a bigger building. Yeah, it's actually pretty sizable. I feel like this is probably going to be our best bet for right here. But then also the reptile, insect, amphibian, and reptile house. So I think we will keep some of the other bigger ones back here. I'd really like to close off some of these ones so that we can actually decorate a little bit. So I think if we come in here and we will flip this around, we'll have this go like right here. Perfect. I think that's going to be great. And then let's go ahead and do our bison one over here. Perfect. Yeah, I think that looks fantastic. The bison one's actually kind of cool. It has a little overlook so that you can see the buffalo on the inside. It's a really awesome little look. And so now we will grab the move it mod, turn this on, pull this out just a smidge, and then go back to our paths. I don't know why I went into paths. I literally was looking at the zoo path right there. So we'll go like this. And then I don't really want it to connect up right away, so I'm going to go ahead and turn those off. And there we go. I do want to straighten this out a little bit. It looks like that's just a little off. That definitely looks good. I like that it comes up over the overlook too. So this would be kind of like a line, or maybe if you just walked up to it, you'd see people on top. And I think this looks really good. I think we need to get a little path back here too. So we are going to grab this, have it go this way. I don't really want people to walk that way, actually. We'll go like right there. And then I'm going to grab the move it mod and shift this around a little bit. Yeah, we'll go like right there. Perfect. I feel like that is pretty good. I don't really want this path to go any further because it'll allow people to bypass the front gate and just go in, which is not good. And so now what I want to do, let's see how close our amusement park is again. Oh man, we're like right there. And there we go. So we hit our next unlock for the amusement park. We got the drop tower and the pendulum ride. Oh man, I'm really, this theme park is coming together. And so now let's jump in here, go to amusement park, and let's figure out what we're going to do with this drop ride. So I would like to fit the roller coaster, but I feel like we're definitely losing out on space. But maybe we'll try to squeeze this in, because how many more rides do we have? So we're not going to do the Ferris wheel because we already have one. So then just the roller coaster. And I feel like maybe this space would fit the roller coaster. So let's see if we can fit these somewhere else. Though this pendulum ride is huge. I did not realize it was that big. I guess I forgot. So I think we're going to go ahead and put the drop tower ride right there. Yeah. I kind of wish it wasn't crowded in there, but I also want to save some space for the roller coaster. So I think what we'll do, and we're going to just cheat a little bit for this, we are going to grab all of this and just move this out a smidge. We're not going to go that far. We're going to go like right there. Yeah, there we go. And then that way we just have a little more space. I was trying not to do that, but I feel like it's just necessary at this point. So we're going to fill that in. And then now what we can do is grab this and just bring it back a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and grab our pathways to or this road. So I'm going to delete that road and then jump back in here, go to one unit road and then have it go all the way across. And voila, it looks like we have the same issue with this one too. I'm going to go ahead and fix this real quick. And there we go. And so now we should have enough space. So I'm thinking put the roller coaster directly across from that. And then let's see if we can fit the pendulum ride like right here. Man, I don't even know if that's still going to be. I wonder. So it looks like if we moved the spinning teacups, we could fit this in the middle. This is going to get rid of our look though. Man, I like the symmetry of it all. I feel like that's really going to be missed. So let's go ahead and move this over. Try to move the teacups right there. And then let's that right there. Perfect. And then we will just have to get rid of this restaurant. And then let's move this right there. And then let's put that right there. Perfect. And so I think we can go ahead and get rid of these now because I don't want to just connect them up to the boardwalk. All right. And there we go. And so I think by moving it in a little bit like that, what it's going to allow us to do is grab our path and go around so that we can still keep that look a little bit. So if we go like right there, and then come up around, perfect. And so now let's look at our last unlock. When do we get the roller coaster? So 10,000 visitors, man, that is a ways away. So it looks like maybe on the next episode, but I think we can start decorating this now, which is fantastic. And so I do want to hook up this little path here too. I was kind of like looking at this. I think that looks great. And this would actually be a really good spot for us to extend our cable cars out. Maybe on the next episode, I'll kind of play around with that and see if we can add some in. Let's see how close we are for this guy. So I think we should be pretty close. Dead person is waiting for transport. It's not good. So 1262 63, how many people do we have coming? We've got a lot of people coming, a lot of people leaving, and a ton of people leaving. Why are so many people leaving? Where are they going? Don't leave. Unless they're all like, man, the amusement park just opened up a new ride. Let's all get out of here. Yeah, it looks like more people are leaving than coming right now. But oh, and another thing I did, I went ahead and zoned this in as high density commercial as well. I really wanted to get some tall buildings back here, some cool stuff. And so this would definitely be like the way to go. Like you would come up here and see the whole waterfall and the waterfront shopping district right here. But as you pulled in, it would just be really cool. Like you'd kind of be able to walk around here and it would just be really enjoyable. I've been to places like this before. It kind of reminds me of like Disney Springs in Orlando, Disney World. But now I'm going to go ahead and start decorating everything up and do a little time lapse for it. And there we go. I went ahead and put in trees in here with some gazebos and just really cleaned it up. I think it looks really good. I decided to do the young lindens around our parking lot just to make it a little bit more, just make it a little cleaner. It does look like we're having some issues here, but man, we are getting a lot of people now. I think it is just crazy. It's looking really good with the trees. And then over here, I went for a more minimal look. I did flowers. Because it's on a pier, I didn't want to do heavy, heavy trees. So I went ahead and did bushes to accentuate the pathways and also to limit access back here. So like people would have to jump over the bush, which in real life, they probably would. But to me, it's almost like a fence. And then for our neighborhoods, I decided to do some organic and local produce, little shops on the front side. We'll have to be careful and make sure that we don't just get the same buildings. We might all the way down, but then I did trees on the inside to cover up all the lines just to clean it up. And then I went ahead and put planters around this, did another plaza. And I honestly really like this. I think this looks great. I like those tiles in there too. I've never used these tiles for this plaza before. And so I think this looks really good. I also put planters on the backside. I think on the last episode, we had kind of forgotten to put them back there. And so yeah, I think it looks really good. I really like what we did today. I didn't put any trees over here. I'm going to go ahead and do trees over here real fast. And there we go. So I went ahead and put in trees just to clean up those lines again. And then I did the young lindens following our road all the way back. I really like this waterfall. I think this looks fantastic. While we were doing that, we did unlock another level. And I think we still have maybe one level left. So if we jump in here and let's go to zoo, I think we got the sea life enclosure, which I'm not sure if we're going to do that here. But then we got the elephant enclosure as well. And we got the flamingo one. Oh, wow. I didn't realize we got that many. So let's see. That one's actually not too big. I think the elephant one is pretty big. Yeah. So I think if we do the elephant one like right here. Yeah, I think this is going to be great. And then let's look at the flamingo one too. So we still do have the lion enclosure too, which we're gonna have to figure out a spot for that. I think we'll do the flamingo one right here, and then let's go ahead and hook up our little path right here. That did kind of mess up our waterfalls a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and hook up our path, probably actually right to the middle there. I feel like that could be good. So if we go like that, yeah, look at that. I feel like that actually looks really nice. I do want to create another little space in here. So if we go like that, and then this still leaves a little room for us to do some paths maybe. We could even do another entrance over here. Not entirely certain just yet, but I think the elephant enclosure is a great addition. I do want to do a little path back here and then create like a nice little dining area for people to grab some food or go to the restroom or something. So we're gonna go ahead and grab these and lower them down. Let's grab that one and lower it down as well. And then let's put in our amenities real fast. And there we go. And I went ahead and put the plaza back here too so that people could overlook the city and kind of see our downtown in the back. I think that's a really good addition. And then I do want to put a couple more gazebos back here too. So if we grab this, let's go this way and we'll just go like right there. And then we're going to jump into City Park and grab these gazebos. And I think we'll do some more shops back here too. Maybe just the restroom and the little restaurant. Because we really want to provide people a lot of avenues to just relax and kind of unwind. Especially a lot of people bring kids and it can just be really stressful. And so we want to give some rest time to the parents as well. Yeah, look at that. So now we got a nice little overlook. I think this looks great. So I'm going to go ahead and throw up some trees for this real quick. And voila, I decided to leave some empty space because we still do have that last unlock. I believe it is the lion enclosure and not that one. Go back here, zoo. Ooh, so we still have a few. So we still have the giraffe enclosure, which I believe is kind of big. The monkey palace, which I know is small. Rhino enclosure and the lion enclosure. And so we still need a lot of space. We'll probably end up building down here as well as on this tier. But honestly, I think this looks really good. Go ahead and let me know what you guys think in the comments. And I'm excited about this. On the next episode, we're going to be building out a marina. And I have pulled some really awesome inspiration from some real life marinas. And so stay tuned for that. It is a fantastic build. And go ahead and let me know what you guys think about this zoo. If you guys have any suggestions or anything, let me know. We are probably going to end up doing either a museum or the Statue of Liberty here. We are getting quite a few comments on the both of those. And so if you enjoyed this episode, you will definitely enjoy the episode on your screen. And thank you so much for watching. I will catch you on Sunday.